Hello everybody, welcome back to God of War Valhalla. I have not played Valhalla for 5 days because I've been very angry because I have not been wanting to touch this game for a while because that last thing just drove me up a wall. It just made me very a little angry where I didn't want to touch this game. So yeah. That's the reason I've been away for a while, because I have not been wanting to play this game at all. But hopefully we're regenerized and we can do it. I'm hoping. I'm going to be very careful. I'm going to be try to take it less damage than I can, hopefully. Just sure. Okay.
To adapt is to lean into the alchemy of turning adversity into advantage.
Oh. The gauntlet of loyalty. How about my chest? Oh yeah. Okay, we're fine. Whatever circle is.
Only true opponent in Valhalla.
I don't even have the points for it. Alright, hold on. Alright, now. Okay. Oh! I'm seeing things.
The elite enemies Valhalla has chosen for you to target will only continue to manifest. You must adapt and employ all available resources, or you will fall again.
I am not trying to fall. Hold on.
Sigrun, how fair are you and your sisters?
With just the three of us to attend to the fallen now, we're short-handed. But we've begun recruiting new shield maidens.
Well, I happen to know of one lass who'd jump at the chance to join your ranks.
You mean Thrud? Sif and Thor's daughter? Believe me, I know. She sought us out before the call even left our lips.
She fights well. And can be trusted.
A recommendation from you, General. With that, how could we ignore her? Not that she'd let us.
Huh.
he again? More to the story?
Yes, when there is time.
I'm trying to be cautious. I'm not trying to get fight reckless. Yeah, close this one.
You wish to tell a story of your first master?
Aye. Seems to be the very story Valhalla has me reliving, in fact. Oberon fancied himself a romantic, you see. Always claimed that love was more important to him than anything. One time, he led his entire entourage on a journey to attend the wedding of some duke or other, near your old neck of the woods. The groom, this lordly prick, had conquered a warrior queen and was marrying her as part of terms for peace. And this, somehow, was so romantic to Oberon that he dragged us across the sea to pay respects. Never mind, he was quarreling with his own queen the entire way! Well, I'll have more of that one, to be sure. There we go. There's nothing, all right. One wants a price from you, brother.
All right.
was saying about my old master and his lofty, so-called romantic ideals. We'd settled in a forest outside of Athens, a place well situated to observing the comings and goings of the Duke's other guests. There we observe the romantic complications of some local use, and Oberon gets it into his head to intervene, bids me fetch him a magical flower that can manipulate the affections of others. Supposedly, the idea was to nobly help true love prevail over the pressure of family arrangements. But what he really wanted was to use the flower to torment his own wife.
I see why you left his service.
Aye.
Wow, that's kind of cruel. Well, not kind of, but it is cruel. Oh, another key, I think.
Notice some short time help.
Ah, shit, crap. Where the? I hear it.
While I'd love to say I left Oberon's service as a matter of principle, the truth is, it was much more a question of pride. If he'd simply shown me more appreciation, who knows how long I might have tolerated his evils. I certainly tolerated plenty from my subsequent employers before I could take no more. If I'm being honest, I was only too happy to offer my complicity in Queen Titania's humiliation.
What did you do?
I caused her to fall in love with something preposterous. An actor.
What did you do?
Thank you.
Ow! Dang it!
Now then, the path should be unlocked. Let's make our way up.
Just exploring real quick. Just so not ready. Oh. Ah, you. Oh. Okay. Ugh.
this boat captain. If you needed his key to save others, why does it seem to bother you so? Your actions in this case seem justified.
The captain was swallowed by the Hydra before I was able to kill it. When I entered its maw to retrieve the key, the captain had somehow survived, dangling over a fall that would surely kill him. I saw the terror in his eyes as he fought to hold on. A bit of relief when he believed I would save him. Instead, I took the key and dropped him to his death. And it was all for nothing. The women were dead by the time I reached them.
And this is what I'm scared of right now, because that's gonna change now.
We meet once more, coast of Sparta.
Time to hunt. That's all I'm gonna say. No, I'm not interested in you guys right now, even though I need a... there we go.
Trent. chariot's attack!
Shut the hell up right now!
Incoming!
Come on!
Incoming, back here!
Where?
You're well on your way to satisfying our power. Right flank.
Man, this is what I was afraid of. God, man. No, I'm not. Man. This is where I'm trying to panic because I know it's gonna get harder. This is where I'm trying to panic a little bit. Shut the hell up, man. Sorry, keep him out.
Great, Kratos.
God. God, everything was going good, man. I'm not gonna be able to do it. Yep, I know I failed.
And they're all dead. Kratos was here.
Whatever, man. Just annoyed. Like, I wasn't asking for something to be easy, but I wasn't asking something to be extremely difficult either. Come on. I'm done now. Come on, man. Where the hell are these things hiding? Oh my gosh, man.
Watch your left. That should be enough slaughter to earn your freedom.
I just want to get out of here now. That's all I want. Okay, that's 5,000. 1,000. I really hate this guy. He gets really annoying. Hate.
Oh, I'm back again. Still not used to that. Hello again, Kratos.
Battle clear your mind.
Defend yourself. Behind you! Look out! Tell me, Kratos, truly, how did it feel to plunge your homeland into darkness?
I did not intend the land to suffer, but I was indifferent. Consumed only by rage and retribution.
That is not what I asked. How did it feel in that moment, your soul given over to darkness, bringing a darkness over everything you could see?
It felt true.
Fight back! Your curse! You better get into the light, brother! Arms up! I yield.
Good then.
I don't think you were indifferent, Kratos. I think you were hurt. Deeply hurt. And you handled it unskillfully.
Wait, is that you restoring the sun? You took Helios's chariot and put the sun back in the sky, but sacrificed yourself in the process.
Yes. I fell to my death, and was saved by Helios. But this memory happened before I killed him. My evils were yet to come. What is the point?
That your legacy has always been a complicated one. That goodness is not a destination we arrive at, but a practice. Misfortune may drive anyone to darkness. We resist it only through wisdom and vigilance. You are not so unskillful now as you were then. Better voices in your head, you might call it. I think that's enough for now. You have much to contemplate.
Yes.
Back to the beach then.
You should be proud of your progress, Kratos. See you soon. Oh.
Seems like you're making progress, whatever you're doing in there.
Perhaps.
Listen, I know I made you feel like we expected more of you than you could give. And I just want you to know, I'm not asking you to change how you are or who you are. We had to break the old world to build a new one. Picking up the pieces and putting them together stronger, it's a rare opportunity. You made a difference here. In some circles, a symbol of change. On many days, just knowing that you're a part of the Council is enough.
And other days?
You've earned a voice. How you use it is up to you.
Alright guys, well, that's it for this video. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Like and subscribe if not already subscribed, and I'll see you in the next one. Take it easy.